Hey, thank you for watching this video. My name is John Belinsky and I'm a physician assistant and I absolutely love helping people understand and learn and more importantly, apply medical principles. Now, I'm an 18-year physician assistant. I've always worked emergency medicine, hospitals, medicine, or critical care. And my career has been a little bit unique where 14 of my 18 years, I worked critical access emergency medicine, which means I didn't have a doc on site. So I've always had to make critical decisions autonomously. So I've run hundreds of codes. Rapid sequence intubation, myocardial infarctions. I've taken care of wicked sick people, and I feel passionate and called to help other people learn, and I teach different. Please YouTube my name, John Belinsky, and see some of the videos of how I teach at conferences. When I graduated high school, well, I didn't. In 1987, I did not graduate with my class because my grades were so bad, okay? I struggled all through high school because I was an atraditional learner. I didn't get a diploma with my graduating class. I actually went into the Marine Corps and got a GED in the Marines. But in Desert Storm over in Combat Action, I learned how to learn. I was always a bright guy. I just didn't learn well with a traditional teaching model. So through kinesthetics repetition, I learned, hey, I can learn anything. And that's how I applied these principles in college and PA school. And as an instructor, I've taught at multiple PA schools, okay, teaching lab medicine, EKG, radiology. And I really get the privilege of lecturing all over the country, teaching people how to truly understand medicine. From conferences perspective, I taught all sorts of emergency medicine topics. And my favorite are to assess someone with chest pain or medical emergencies, shortness of breath, EKG interpretation, which I have an advanced program filled with mnemonics that I get rave reviews on, chest radiograph interpretation or peripheral radiograph interpretation. I love teaching people about thinking, how to think, the biases that we have in medicine. So I do lecture on medical errors, and that particular lecture has been requested twice by the AAPA for their national conference. I love lecturing on influence. How do we get patients more compliant to say yes? How do we get parents happy that they're not getting an antibiotic? Or how do we get consultants willing to admit our patients and not give us a lot of hassle with it? Now, also what we can offer you is self-assessment and performance improvement, Category 1 CME. Now, we do a 20-hour self-assessment that can be completed in 5 hours of live conference. What do I mean by that? We have been approved for a 5-hour conference where it's self-assessment through audience response units. We do it either in acute care medicine or board review preparation where for 5 hours, we ask questions in a PowerPoint presentation. Everybody from their seats responds with an audience response unit. We immediately give them feedback. Now, 5 hours in class equals 10 hours of Category 1 CME. Yeah, that's exactly right. 5 hours in class has been approved for 10 hours of self-assessment. And then they do a take-home test. That take-home test is worth 10 hours. So if you employ us, what we can do is allow you to offer your registrants 20 hours of Category 1 CME, and they do it in 5 hours. What we just did at the North Carolina Academy of Physician Assistants is we offered it in the evening time on 2 different days, and we had 160 people, 2 rave reviews. It was an awesome learning experience. Also, what we can do is offer performance improvement. Now, this is a take-home performance improvement that has to do with patient satisfaction, so it's ubiquitous. It can be used in emergency medicine, urgent care, cardiology, pain control, surgery. It's on patient satisfaction, and it works awesome. What it is they have to get some data, patient satisfaction data, whether it's from internal Prasgini-like scores or they have to hand out 10 surveys. Then they apply our system of extraordinary patient care, medical error reduction and influence, and then 3 to 6 months later, they redo the study, send us that data, and then we can issue them a 20 credit of performance improvement. It's a wonderful addition and almost like an upsell to people coming to your conference. We would handle all the certification part of it. So keep us in mind. Again, my name is John Belinsky. I'm the owner of CME for Life. Our whole goal is to maximize your mind, maximize people's ability to take in information and apply it when they see a patient. So please consider allowing me to speak at your conference. I'd feel blessed and privileged to do that. Thank you for watching. Thank you for your consideration.